Hello, everyone, and welcome in here to some more NBA 2K16 My Career Year 4 on the short morning sports stream on this Tuesday morning. Looks like everything's functioning correctly, which I love. I always love getting off. No technical difficulties. Although I don't know many streamers who like to have technical difficulties. I think that's a pretty good consensus throughout the community that no one likes that. Anyway, back here in year four, we're going to pick things up here. A couple road games. A lot of road games here. Getting closer and closer to All-Star Weekend. But first up, looks like got the Rockets. Let's see. What I want to go with. Yeah, let's do some more pinstripe stuff.
It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
Hello and welcome, everybody. Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith. We're glad to have you with us on 2K Sport. And tonight, it'll be the Houston Rockets going up against the Indiana Pacers. Checking out the Pacers, they haven't forgotten
Oops,
the fact
that's
that this
I
team
to do.
Swept them last
there we
year
go.
In the season. This is a game they had circled going in. And All-Star Weekend approaching, always a big stage, but how desirable
lovely first Tuesday of the month.
To be in a big market.
The tornado siren going off, the usual test.
No.
I don't know if the Miami mic really picks that up at all.
Won the NBA championship, small market team.
And I get to hear it nice and loudly because it's like a
win the NBA
small market team. Yeah, block away from my house. I was trying to think if it was two blocks or one. It's one block.
Guys want to be on good teams, great teams. That's more memorable than being in a place that
– But, you know, it's – a good thing because, you know, if a tornado ever does happen, I'm sure not going to miss the signal because it's that close. So, while it can be a little annoying, you know, on the first Tuesday because it's like, never mind, first Tuesday. It's one of those things where, like, if it actually needed to be used, then it would be, it's very nice having it that close.
We welcome you this Thursday evening as we get set for some exciting NBA action.
Woo! NBA action!
I'm Kevin Harlan with Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony and Doris Burke reporting from the
sideline. See if I can get away with following people.
Here in Houston, it's another home game for the Rockets.
Or if I run by someone in the crowd, will they touch me? I don't know.
Facing off against a team that has every expectation of beating them, they'll need to play a complete game to snare a win.
And you know, Houston, their place in the standings would be a disappointment for just about any team. But especially
there's Dwight Howard, who's probably going to be gone at the end of the season. And here's me driving right through the lane because no one's going to play defense.
Decisions have been questionable, coaching has been shaky, and players have performed at a subpar level.
Let's check out Indiana's starting lineup. Moore, he's in at power forward. Ellis is out there with George Hill.
That's
Paul George, and it's Olynyk at the five, roaming the paint. Now here's Monty Unis. He's a good contributor to his team, averaging
that's
going to
go in.
A game.
And his presence
can't even afford
scorer,
to give him
just
an inch of space
for the rest of the team. He's a fallback option whenever they need one.
Here's Ellis. First quarter of play, 1 minute played.
Oh, nice. There's that 80 contact dunk coming into play, although I know that ended up being a layup.
The Pacers shooting their first free throw attempt on the night.
All right, Olynyk and one.
In terms of their attempts, 81%.
Yeah, in general, they've been very solid. I mean, free throw shooting isn't something they've had to worry about too much this season.
Whoa, okay. That's what I just did on the last two possessions ago.
And so here is Indiana. They come into this one having outplayed the Magic last game.
Deadly from behind the three-point line in that game. And it
looks
really
like that's going
to
be there all day.
To stretch that defense out.
Yeah, I agree with you. I mean, it opened things up for them in a big way. The defense was never.
Yeah, I mean, I didn't watch the game live last night, but I saw highlights and all that. And,
out to the right wing.
Austin has of all the controversy from with his three. Last night's Spurs and Oklahoma City Thunder game. I guess I could have just said Thunder. I don't know why I had to say the whole thing. Yeah, A little interesting, that's for sure.
They get it back. Moore. Blanketed by the D, he fights to the rim for the layup.
At least the league admits they missed the call. I mean, while it's a little too late.
From the game, so early offensively they've been great. That's the way.
At least they're like, yeah, we screwed up.
That is in there. Washington with the assist. 5 points in the game.
You know, the defense has got to do a much better job of fighting over those screens.
And Greg, especially when the ball is in his hands. I mean, come on now. You know, he doesn't miss.
I'm just going to be able to do this all day against Monty Yunus as long as he keeps playing me like that.
I like his vision, guys. He sees everything.
First quarter of basketball, just over 2.5 minutes play. The offensive rebound.
You kicked that out of there.
He has a wide open look.
And
three for Houston.
And he is really in a zone right now.
Don't kick it out to him, though.
Hill kicks to Moore. There's the feed to George. Shoots. And the shot is long. Houston's gone 2 or 3 from deep so far in this game. Here's Lawson. And he gets it to go.
Wow.
Really aggressive play.
Looks like
there.
It's going to be a pretty close game
against the big fella.
You know, Greg, aggressiveness is really the only option when you're on the wrong side of the size equation.
Now here's Moore. A 17-point game for him in the win against Orlando.
It's going to be more than a 17-point game in this one.
Block shots. It also altered a ton of shots.
Here's Lawson. Following the basket by Freak, Harden kicks to Howard.
Whoops.
Goes in for the dunk.
Whoa, whoa.
Ah, black. Come on, wake up.
Is he an athlete or what?
No doubt about it. It's almost as if he lives in the air, and dunks like that have become quite commonplace.
Now, here is George. Coming in off a
10-point game. I'm running around in a circle.
Rockets have gone 6 of 9, shooting it well.
Now, there have been a lot of interesting calls. You know, I've seen a league a lot of times. Say no, well we screwed up. Sorry.
Just 5 on the clock for 3. Lawson. Lawson can't get that one to fall. For Indiana, they've gone 7 of 9 from the field. A really nice start offensively for them, and a wide open look for Freak. With the 3-point shot. And for Houston, they're shooting an impressive 60% early. Here's Ariza.
Like I said, it's nice that they're admitting they have. I guess it's nice that they're admitting they have. They're got a problem that they've made mistakes, but.
Innovation and improvisation right there, Greg. Finding a way to get that shot to fall.
That's like punching somebody in the face and then apologizing for it later on. After you've already done it.
And it's Patrick Beverly in for Ty Lawson. And here's Beverly. Following the 3-pointer by Freak.
Well after you've already done it, and there's nothing Ariza you can do about it to change it.
Beverly, the pass to Ariza. Another miss by Houston. For Indiana, they've gone 8 of 11 in the first quarter.
Oh, well, I guess they did apologize pretty quickly.
There's the pick.
Still, it's a little too late. You've already when punched the person in the face.
In the corner, Miles with it.
Chance oh, Miles.
Missing. Houston's gone 2 of 4 from beyond the arc to start the game. Stolen by Jeremy Lin. And now the fast break. Hill with the ball. About 3 seconds between shot and game clock.
Moore. Decker just standing there like
in this quarter. The game plan is simple.
I'm behind you.
Get in the ball and get out of the way.
Beverly with the ball. Looking for his first basket still in this one. Screen by Howard. Here's Brewer. A 3-pointer off the mark.
Good little 2-man action.
Oh,
there,
no.
But they just can't get the
it's
shot.
It's good.
Yeah, but that was a beautiful, good-looking shot, well-executed play. I wouldn't be surprised to see them go back to it.
And that concludes a back-and-forth, high-scoring first quarter of play. Pacers
Let's
lead
see
by
here.
Two.
So, yeah, but like I said, I didn't watch any of the game right itself this. Last night. I had a... had a date with HBO Now to catch up on Game of Thrones since I didn't watch it Sunday, and I needed to catch up before the Spoilers. Spoilers got out there because I told you I was watching WWE Payback Sunday. And had to get off Twitter because luckily non-spoilers, but they were starting to roll in there.
That's an interesting perspective on competitiveness and what happens.
All I have to say is, holy Game of Thrones. That was a great episode.
Yeah, you know, I certainly understand where he's coming from. I mean, I'm living it in many ways, but for
run
me,
the offense through me.
The game and
got it. All right, give me the ball.
Give me the ball. The same things I do, whether they ever played or not. There's some common ground, even outside of the competitive court.
Well, up to this point, a closely contested game as we start the second quarter. And a chance for just a second to check out the scoring breakdown for Indiana.
Fellas, they're passing the ball the way you're supposed to here in this first half.
Something else.
Nowhere to go
to
with
so
that one. What's going on?
Then there's Brewer. Then it's Patrick.
Okay, he missed. We're good. Everything's good.
And a chance here to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Doris Burke. Hi, Doris.
Well, Kev, Freak in the last matchup against the Magic was simply terrific.
Ah, that wasn't what I wanted to do. Pass it to me when I want you to pass it to me.
Numbers like that make you anxious to see what he can do next time out.
Thanks for the great report, Doris. Guys, the way he carried them.
Well, that directive quickly got canceled because I screwed up.
He was literally on
another planet. Well, not me.
In that game, he did it all. On the floor.
My teammates.
What's interesting to me, guys, is to see how much energy he's.
Oh, okay. Well, now I'll put on a show. Okay.
A little heavy from that last game.
A chance now to check out the NBA's most efficient scores. Freak number.
When I watch, I'll be on the bench coming out. Okay. I've gotten that. You put on a show and you're bench.
Efficiency. Taking advantage of your opportunities at a high rate.
James Harden, he's checked in for Brewer. Indiana also making some changes.
Stop my momentum.
Paul George comes in for
him,
and it's Ellison for C.J. Miles. Now here's Lynn, still getting warmed up.
There we go.
No buckets yet in the game for him.
And there's a little freaking imbibing for the crowd.
I mean, his shooting has led them to this lead.
Excuse me, coming through. I need to get over here to Sam Decker.
The shot is off. Good work defensively by Turner. And now here's George, the fast break opportunity. More inside.
Oh!
Nice shot by Lynn.
Did you see James Harden kind of sort
of
playing defense?
That's
funny.
Down low.
It's becoming a theme in this game, Clark. They are piling up the points in the paint.
Now here's Harden. He's got eight. Will not go. This is off the front.
No, it will not.
Pacers leading by three. It's George on the wing, guarded by Harden. The shot by George, no good.
Well, I think the defense got lucky right there. I mean, he's going to make a lot more of those than he misses when he's got that much room.
Those are chances almost always you can rely on him to get you.
Good. Oh, and one.
To keep him out of rhythm.
And, yep, that's going to be
that
a flagrant foul. Unnecessary contact.
And Kevin, I got to tell you, he's probably fortunate to just get a flagrant one there. I mean, so much contact. The officials easily could have gone even harder on him.
Greg, I agree. He better be on his best behavior from now on. One more flagrant of any variety, and he's out of here. The Rockets making a switch
here.
He's
out of here.
Indiana also making some changes. Olenek, he's checked in for Turner. And it's Hill in for Jeremy Lin. And Moore kicks to Ellis. And once again off the mark by Indiana.
Uh-oh.
Tell you what, you can shake your confidence missing wide open shots like that.
Bazemore dishes to Lawson. He kicks it to Mantiunas. To end the run, it's Harden.
Yep, no one's going to step over.
That's where the weight room comes into play, Kevin.
I think some urgency from him there.
Hey, I think he's sensing that this is a critical time in the game, fellas.
And
am I putting on a show enough yet?
Maybe could have tried for a more memorable dunk than that.
And I'm also running the offense through me. Can I get a double bonus objective? Oh, wow. I shouldn't have stepped away from that.
A lot more engaging and entertaining than just doing the old ho-hum one-hander.
Hill passes to Olenek. It's Ellis on the wing. He's now 1-for-2 with that bucket.
I love how bad, he establishes Alice. His post position inside before he converts.
Rockets trail by 6.
Dun, 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 dun.
Lawson up top. He's guarded by Hill. Lawson kicks to Harden, and he gets the bucket. Harden's got 12 points.
All right,
on the game.
All right, all right.
Really,
come on now.
A tremendous day for him. And if you remember, he was just as good in their last game.
More dishes to soft touch off the glass.
Just too easy there. Back up to 6 now for the love it when they bring the double team
to finish that one off.
Got someone standing wide open underneath the basket. Love when that double team happens. I like the one where we get three-pointers too, but that's a little more of a surefire thing getting that layup. All right. Still got to put on a show.
He's checked in for Monta Ellis. Reza comes in for Declan.
Except out. There we go. Now here's the one where I'm on the bench. So, do I get a good grade? Put on a show, right? If you're looking at Rodney, I see you out of the corner of my eye.
And we're through the first half of basketball.
Oh, and they got a 2-point lead.
What's your assessment of the team?
Wow. Simulation. Not been kind to us. This may be one that goes down to the wire. That's okay. I haven't had one of those in a... didn't have one last stream. One that kind of went to the fourth quarter.
And it's been a back-and-forth game so far with no ground given through the first half. Third quarter starting here now. You look at Freak in this game. He has been everywhere.
And he's been a
because I'm a freak. All right, hold on. Before we get called for 10 seconds.
The rim would even survive in that first half.
And the interior defense has to get tougher here in the second half. He's making them look really bad.
On the court for Indiana. Blah, blah, blah.
In at power forward. George Hill out there with Ellis.
Oh, and it's misses
George
the layup.
In forward position. Now, here is George. Following the miss by Trevor Ariza. Near the three-point line, it's Ellis. That misses, had a chance to tie it there. Houston's gone 4-of-8 tonight from three-point land, shooting 50% on the three ball here.
And they're going out and running.
Ariza has the open look. Ariza with another miss. Indiana trailing here. Ellis outside.
Get the ball inside.
And stolen by
no!
Ariza.
Oh, Ellis, always the with the turnovers.
And Harden gets it to go in on the assist by Ariza. 19 points for James Harden.
Such a strong finisher on the fast break.
And Greg, I love the fact he's always in control. Even though he's going at breakneck speed, he still maintains his body control.
Now here's Ellis. A look at his stats. He averages a bit over 8 points a game. Shot clock at 5. Ariza brings the double. And Hill has it.
That's not who I wanted to go to.
And 2 free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there. That one on George.
Really, the right play defensively, if you can't block, force him to the line.
Yeah, exactly. Prevent the layup. Give him a little bump. And then
I hit the A button to pass to George right as I was hitting the RB button.
If they don't think about it, at least they might be distracted by your
to do icon passing, and yep.
He gives the team some
ended up throwing it to Hill instead of George.
Kept alive. And more kicks to Olynyk. And
so to the line. Official saw the wish you would have finished that, Olynyk.
The Pacers shooting their third and fourth free throw shots of the night. That one is off. Deckers check in for Houston. He's off on the second.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Where did this go so wrong?
Pass to Lawson.
That's one for their first 4 to start the second half.
To the inside.
And screw it. We're running a fast break. You gotta get finally do something to get us kick started here.
First 4 here in the third.
Lawson outside. Pass to Monta Ellis. Harden against Ellis. Odiunis has the open look. Traps in the tray.
Wow.
Odiunis has got his second basket of the night.
That was some slick passing from Harden on that one.
Feeds it to Moore. Fires from the wing. That's good.
Yeah, one of the
double team on me don't matter.
For his team. I mean, he's had
I had space anyway backing up there.
No telling how much larger the lead would be if it wasn't for his shooting. I mean, come on, this guy's kept him in.
Here's Lawson. Following the basket by Freak, Howard can't hit.
Yeah.
Ellis, the pass to Olenek. Again, Indiana.
Okay, okay.
Just a major size difference between the defender.
A little momentum back here.
And Greg, without a hand in his face, he's simply going to spray whoever's there.
He'd only be down by one if somebody hit his free throws. Not going to say who that was. Olenek.
Check the pin with Doris Burke. Doris?
Guys, over that last break, I listened to Kevin McHale address his team. He made no mistake that Dwight Howard has got to be the focal point of their offense. Coach is looking for him to take on a lot of responsibility when they've got the ball, to be a leader at the offensive end. Probably a good time to make some changes with a good chunk of the second half still to go, Kevin.
All right, it's all right.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, the defender all over.
Greg, he got him good there. I mean, that's why the shot was so far off.
Rockets have been excellent at the free throw line here today. A flawless 6-for-6.
And the season numbers for them at the line thus far are really poor. Something I'm sure
just
they
make
are
them earn
a
it.
Point of emphasis.
You know, the numbers from the line, guys, are close to where they were last year.
Let's get the ball inside.
But just a tad worse, so not too bad.
The Pacers making a switch here. Miles has checked in.
Lynn's oh no! I jumped too early.
That's a shot he's got to hit. You don't get.
Wish he would have waited half a second for me to.
Kicks it to Moneyunis. A picture perfect screenplay in the jump.
So he can pass it to
me. Has got the lead up to seven now for the Rockets.
Man, we go on one run and then they answer right back.
Lynn against Beverly. Outside Hill. Out to the wing. Moore dishes to Lynn. Some nice passing here by Indiana. And Moore kicks to Turner.
Good. Finish. Yes.
Turner's got his first 2 points of the night.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Yeah, I think they've got to ramp up the aggressiveness, Greg. I mean, if they don't, things are just going to get worse from here.
Now, here's Beverly. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for him.
Stuff.
And Kevin, plays like that really the reason they've got a nice lead right now. Just a great job on the glass.
And Greg, the jam and the follow gets their whole
can't
bench
make passes
jumping.
Like
Clark,
that.
They are really into it.
Yeah, they sure are. That's a little salt in the wound there. I mean, they take a miss and turn it into one of the plays of the game. That hurts.
Oh, the officials are all over that one.
Clearly a foul. I mean, didn't give them any choice but to blow the whistle. I mean, you got to play without fouling. Can you believe the job they're doing at the foul line since halftime? I mean,
you're a bench me? All right, well, at least it's brought us back within
last
four.
For Houston, it was a loss to the Magic. Lawson out there with Harden. Then it's Trevor Ariza. Then there's Brewer. And it's Howard in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. So that's who's on the floor for the Rockets. Lynn kicks to Moore. Just four to shoot. Let's it go. In close, he hits it.
Moore's take advantage of that mismatch there. Ariza may be able to play power forward, but I don't think he's too best suited to guard me.
Lawson the pass to Ariza. And Lawson, here we go.
Moore nope, I'm going to send that one away. Almost knocked it in.
Harden against Ellis. Dishes it to Lynn. Moore inside, covered by Brewer. And Moore kicks to Turner. And a foul on the shot. He'll go for two.
All the officials are all over
okay.
That.
Clearly, we've gone up with that shot. Choice, kind of a goofy I mean, double team, then not a double team. And suddenly I'm standing all by myself down there.
Offensive approach for the Rockets.
So far, they've turned in a fantastic performance from the three-point
line. Luckily, Turner's the second-best free-throw shooter on this team.
For the layups they've had tonight after strong drives to the basket.
And the Rockets making a change here. Monta Yunus has checked in. And Indiana with a change here, too. George Hill's checked in for Jeremy Lin.
We're seeing today what makes him one of the best free-throw shooters among the league's big men. Beautiful stroke.
Boston outside.
And Turner's got to be within the top 10 on free throw percentage. I'll have to check that out.
Fires for three. Rebounded by Moore.
I'm not even sure if that just came directly to me or if that was off the rim.
Hill kicks to Ellis to take the lead. Good D by Lawson. Houston's gone to the three-pointer 11 times tonight, nailed five of them. Inside, the dish to Howard. Harden outside.
Whew, Monta Yunus wasn't standing any closer. Oh, no.
Monta Yunus' shot is good. And the Rockets lead by three.
Boy, that's a nice feed by Lawson.
Monta Yunus has gone 4 of 5 shooting from the field. Now, here is Hill. Pass to Moore. And lots of contact.
Yeah, there we go. That'll work.
Shot. He'll shoot two. That's on Dwight Howard.
Really an extraordinary game for Freak. He has 9 rebounds and some big-time point production as well. He's getting it done, making plays by setting up his teammates and grabbing some nice boards, too.
And also, how about the intangibles? All the little things that he's done. That's also really important.
Kelly Olynyk checked in for Indiana.
Oh, no, 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 no. Keep Turner in.
At the free throw line.
Can I go to the bench and suggest that? We want Turner. We want Turner. On the fast break, I can do that.
Well, guys, Kevin McHale had some advice for the team.
We want Turner.
He said, guys, this is the kind of game we're capable of playing when we put our minds to it. I knew we had it in us. Just like I know we're going to come out on top. Let's finish this thing. Guys.
The pass to Ariza. That's good. And
wow.
So Howard with the assist. That's now 8 points for Trevor Ariza.
That's some grit and determination in the post. Essential qualities to have late in a close game.
Exactly. This is the time to attack on the interior and convert
now,
those easy
Now, defensive stop. Here we
now
go.
Is not the time to be giving him that kind of shot.
Howard with a screen on Hill. Lawson, the open look. And Houston again with the bucket.
You know, the defense has got to do a much better job of fighting over those screens.
And Greg, especially when the ball is in his hands. I mean, come on now. You know he doesn't miss too many open looks like that.
There we go. That's what we needed.
Tied up now for the Pacers.
Confident and composed on the three-point shot at a critical juncture. Clutch.
Yeah.
Harden dishes to Lawson. He feeds it to Howard. And out of bounds.
I forced you to dribble out of bounds.
I mean, I guess he had more than he did.
Hey, don't push me, ref. Rude.
Well, if you're just tuning in, welcome. We've got about 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth quarter. It's stolen by Ariza.
And of course we turn it over, because why wouldn't we?
Finishes the break with a slam.
How about that one man fast break?
I love the power finish at the end of it, too.
Patrick Beverley, he's checked in for Ty Lawson. And here are the Pacers now.
You got it. Let's get the ball inside.
Here's Hill. To the middle. Here's Moore.
Everyone, get out of my way.
Contact on the way up, and two shots coming up.
Yeah, I like
goodness, James Harden fouled me.
Here in the second, despite being down.
That's exactly when you need to be aggressive, Greg.
Everyone likes to run where I'm running.
Good job, though, of drawing contact and getting to the free throw line.
And so Moore nails both of them.
Good thing I'm all pretty much automatic from the line.
You want at the line in that situation. It just shows you how much he loves these moments.
Harden outside. Left side Ariza. This one for three. It's good.
Dang it.
From Harden. Harden's got four assists in the game. Pacers trail by three. Ellis kicks to George. Olynyk inside, working on Mone Yunus.
Okay,
you know,
okay.
That's going to be goaltending, guys, so that's a free basket right there.
Ooh, he's playing hard, but you got to play smart, too. Get there too late, and that's a big whistle.
Okay, defense.
We got to be
defense. Can't stress this enough.
Get into them on the perimeter. Post, rotate over, and make your presence felt.
There's a minute 47 left in the fourth quarter. It's Harden with the drive. Step back shot. Can't hit.
Finally. All right.
I tell you what, that's too good a look to pass up there. Even though it didn't go, that's one you got to take.
George with no one around. And again, it's Indiana.
And thus far, they've managed to overcome an off game.
Now, can we get another stop? That is the question. That is always the question. Oh no. That's my fault there. I got greedy and went for the steal.
Harden's got assist number five here tonight. Pacers have gone 5 of 7 from the field since the beginning of the fourth. Strong work at that end of the floor. Moore passes to George. Back to Moore.
No! What?
Monty Ennis has got rebound number five here tonight.
Got to be kidding me.
Harden against George. Harden dishes to Beverly. Nails the triple.
That
wow.
You know it. He's stepping right into the spotlight there.
And the Pacers shooting a smooth 58% from the field.
Can't believe I missed that dunk.
For them on that end. And George kicks to Moore. He dishes it to Hill. Five on the clock. Indiana needs to get a shot off. Sinks it, and he has brought them to within 2 points.
And that's
okay. I didn't mean to do pump fake there. Just wanted to go for a straight layup.
They'll be trying to take as much time off the clock as they can.
Exactly. Expect to see some long possessions out of them going forward.
It's 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock.
Dang it, Olynyk.
Point from this point on, it seems like they're just closer to finishing this one off.
If they haven't already done it, I mean. Hey, it's been
yeah, that may be game right there.
From this group.
Can't believe I missed that
any
dunk.
About that.
And so here is Indiana.
Count it! And that shot sucked the life out of the whole building.
Well, that was a big one, Clark. You could hear it.
And sometimes the silence of a crowd can speak volume.
Oh, I want to be up there to try to get the steal.
To stop the clock. That's the enemy in this situation.
And you know what, Greg? Who knows? A few misses at the strike.
And now we send him right to one of the best free throw shooters free to the line.
A lot different than early game free throws in terms of making.
So he goes 2 for 2 at the line, and it's a 4-point ball game.
And that makes it a 2-possession game now. Those could turn out to be vital free throws.
17 seconds left in the fourth. Moore outside from downtown. It falls! And what a sensational bucket to bring them within one.
And when you've got a big man who can shoot from distance like that, what a huge advantage.
So the first one
dang.
Drops, and that will put them up by 2. Second one is good. Getting both at the line, and it's a 3-point game.
Yeah, those free throws make things.
Can I get one more 3-pointer?
Right now, they just have to guard against the 3-pointer.
Here's Hill. Moore outside.
But they recover it. Off target from downtown. They foul intentionally. That's what they have to do at this point.
No choice but to foul there, but he's probably the last guy you want to see on the line.
I should have gone really found someone for a better look than that.
And a tough break as his second attempt at the line, no good.
And wow. So it's
a victory for Houston, pulling it out for the W.
It was. Dang it, wow, that's not really how I wanted to start this stream.
Yeah, you got it this time, man.
Get out of here, Harden.
Not happening, Freak. Keep dreaming, though. Hit me up when you get a chance. Got some stuff to talk to you about.
All right, we'll do.
Hey, I'm serious. We're going to get you next time.
The yeah, if the rest of my team doesn't play defense like James Harden. I mean, that... I know the missed dunk was crucial, but...
Welcome back, everybody. Ernie Johnson here along with Shaq
it's
and
just
the Jets.
No one... We couldn't get a defensive stop. That was the problem. We just... Everyone was scoring.
Well, everyone wanted to come play
tonight,
but I
don't want to watch this.
And that'll do it for this edition of the NBA on 2K Sports.
Wow. Well, I guess you can't win them all. I definitely should have looked for a better shot there at the end. Pass it off, set a screen, something. Tried to do too much by myself. Alright, what do we got here? So, what was Harden talking about? I guess maybe that'll come up later. Now, let's see if we can beat up the Bobcats. I mean, the Hornets. Go with the alternates. Let's see, classic home. There we go, classic away. Keeping my promise, saying the next time I played the Hornets, I was going to play him as the Bobcats. But then I forgot and played him as the Hornets anyway. 2K Sport.
In this game, we'll see the Indiana Pacers against the Charlotte Hornets. Checking out the Hornets, they're not satisfied with the record over the last 10 games.
Probably should have gone with a layup instead of a dunk on that one possession. The one that I missed.
Some players come and go over the last couple of years. When you look at this composition of this Hornets team, Shaq, which player do you think is most vital for
their success? Well, Al Jefferson, a.k.a. Baby Fundamentals, is their leader on the floor, on and off the court. From a pure numbers standpoint, Ernie, he's the guy giving the team the highest offensive production.
Hey, don't forget about Kemba Walker, man. And we forget about him when we talk about handles in the NBA. He's in the top five. He's not one, two, or three, but he's in the top
10,
five.
Not top five.
Yeah. Argue with yourselves later. I just need to get some redemption here.
It's the Pacers in Indianapolis as we bring you an Eastern Conference contest. It's the NBA, and it's right here on 2K.
Let's go, Bobcat!
This is Kevin Harlan with Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony. Taking a look at Charlotte. Well, they're certainly excited about this one. It'll be laying it all on the line as the intensity is palpable. Two top caliber teams facing off on the hardwood to do battle.
And when I look at Charlotte, they'd probably say they'd expect to be a little higher
Brick.
In the standings at this point, but can't get too down.
I guess Charlotte, I haven't really looked at the standings lately to see where Charlotte is, but
you know, they're typically a team that expects
we must
be
well, I know we're top of the East.
If not, maybe it'll galvanize them for their playoff push.
And a look at the starters for the Hornets. Kemba Walker is out there with Will Barton. Then there's Al Jefferson. Then
Olenek.
There's Michael Kidd-Gilchrist. And it's Gibson in at power forward. Now here's Walker. Outside Kidd-Gilchrist. Oh, and that one had the right spin on it, and it is
good. Of course, it's a defensive breakdown. What do you expect?
First bucket of the night. Ellis goes in. That's good.
Matched up against a small forward there.
And so here's Charlotte coming off that loss against.
Those practices have done nothing for me.
To make threes in that game.
Oh, okay.
Them, I think is why they ended up on the short end of the stick.
Yeah, they did.
I think I was close enough to him to foul him, but go with that.
With a strong inside game, but their inside game just wasn't strong enough.
That one is no good. On defense, the Hornets.
I need to record a stat other than foul.
Here's more. It's rebounded by
that's
Kid Gilchrist.
That's not going to help.
And here's Charlotte. Last time they met was in Charlotte.
And really, given how they performed offensively, guys, they just never had a chance.
Yeah, and you can see the frustration.
Need to calm down. I'm trying to force offense here.
Empty on their possession.
Trying to redeem for that
they
loss.
Were just happy to watch the clock wind down and move on.
Now, here is George. Following the miss by Freak, shots good by Ellis.
A lot of times in the first quarter, it will dictate how big a role a player has later on.
And Walker kicks to Gibson. The shot is off, and Indiana will go the other way with it. Tough loss coming against the Rockets in the last game they played.
Yeah, they just caught a team, Kevin, that was in a zone, and they didn't have the manpower defensively to disrupt them.
Hey, zone or no zone, I expected a little more fight out of them than what they showed. I mean, they never strung together any stops like they needed to.
Nope. No, we did not.
The miss by Monte Ellis. And it's Gibson that time on the assist by Walker.
Well, he knew how many inches he had over the guy. I mean, let's face it, good decision to just rise up and take the jump shot.
Here's Ellis. The 10-footer finds the target. Ellis has got 7 points in the game. Hornets have gone 2 of 3 here to start out the game. And it's Walker penetrating. It's rebounded by Indiana.
Hey, there we go. Finally got something in the stack category.
Trying to look good. That's a bad decision and poor execution.
And George kicks to Moore. Pick up by Hill. Off the pick. And Freak
throws it down. In coming.
The execution. On that play.
Oh, did they minus me for holding the ball too long?
And the finish wasn't too bad either.
Oh, that's funny.
Perfectly designed and perfectly executed.
And it's Walker again missing.
Well, that's an excellent challenge right there. Good job contesting that shot by the defender.
Nobody near George. Off target from 3-point range.
Boy, even though he missed, you can't give up that kind
steal
of
it.
A look very
steal
often.
It.
The better to be lucky than good sometimes. Fortunately, they didn't get burned on that one.
And Gibson, here we go.
Oh, that's terrific defense there. That's how you protect the rim.
And a wide open look for Freak. Rebound, Kemba Walker.
Most of the time, that shot will go down. Boy, the defenders have to make sure they tag him.
To the middle. Here's Jefferson.
Nope.
With the block. Hill kicks to George. Good, and it's Hill picking up the assist.
There we go.
George has got his first points of the night.
Oh, I tell you what, nice little run here they're going on.
A little bit of a rough
to
start to this
has
game
been
for
the
me.
Key. They're getting point blank looks time and time again.
Here's time Bobby. After
looking
time.
First basket still on this one. Off to a good start as he hits his first shot attempt.
Well, that's simply a great move there, Kevin. He dusted off the defense and got to the cup for the easy basket.
Kid Gilchrist against George. Down low, here's Moore. And Gibson sends it back. And it's Kid Gilchrist penetrating. Excellent D there from George.
You know what? His finishing ability, not really at the level that you would expect from a pro, but he's going to have to start playing with more force.
Really need to learn to go sometimes for layups instead of dunks. A little bit of a quicker release. Already getting sent to the bench. What am I, 1 for 4? Yep.
So Indiana ends up. Moore in at the 4 spot. Jeremy Lin is out there with C.J. Miles. Then it's Turner. And it's Hill in at the small forward spot. That's the five to begin the second quarter for the Pacers.
Solid on the one-hand throw down there.
You know, Clark, when it's a tight ball game like this, he's the guy they want with the ball.
Yep.
Yeah, and one reason why. I just don't know that I've ever seen him miss a play like that.
Let's go to our sideline reporter, Doris Burke. Doris, what do you have?
Well, Kev, Freak in the last
matchup against the Rockets. Shot over Kaminsky there.
He ended up with 38 points and was his usual self on the glass, grabbing just about any missed shot that came off the rim. Absolutely amazing numbers.
Except there wasn't too many missed shots because no one could, well, you know.
All right, Doris, thanks so much.
Force a stop. They were hitting everything.
What he was able to do that night, didn't you?
You know what? It was the game of basketball being played at its highest level. No question who their MVP was in that win.
No question whatsoever, Greg. I mean, that's a performance he and his fans
will
remember for a long, long time. You know, that's been a big part
of
their
just calm down.
The
offense
stage.
Come
I mean,
to me, take advantage of
the
mismatches like that when I get them.
From close range, right at the rim.
And Clark, they might as well keep doing it. I mean, attack the basket until the defense makes an adjustment.
Now here's Lynn, following the miss by Austin Rivers. And we're a little over a minute and a half into the second quarter of action. Six on the shot clock. And Freak.
There you go.
Tell you what, he can do a lot more damage to that rim than that when he wants to.
And you know, Clark, with the lead.
Hello,
I'm
open.
Put a little something extra on that.
Pass it to me.
Well, I tell you what, I'm glad he didn't, because otherwise we'd probably have a 45-minute delay here if he shattered the backboard. And how's
that going here now offensively?
It's a thing of beauty.
Freak sets a screen for Lynn. Dishes at DeMore.
No, what was that? Oh, did I still had the icon passing off.
Count it, and the Pacer lead has been cut down now to just five on the bucket from Kevin Martin.
Wow, the floor just really opened up for him on that possession.
Yeah, I mean, I'm all for good offense. Action from the defense.
So an entirely new group in now for Indiana. Olenek is checked in for Turner. Paul George comes in for Hill. Ellis is checked in for C.J. Miles. And it's Hill in for Jeremy Lin. Charlotte also making some changes. Michael Kidd-Gilchrist is checked in for Martin. Will Barton comes in for Austin Rivers. And it's Kemba Walker in for Jared Bayless. Shot clock at five. And the Pacers can't get it to go. Hornets trail by five. Walker the pass to Jefferson. Here's Kaminsky. Rebound by Olenek. The Pacers have gone 3 of 4 from the floor here in the second quarter. Moore right side. Nice spin off the left rim and in.
Now MKG almost blocked that.
You know, he's had better starts, obviously, but he's shaking it off here in the second.
Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. Barton dishes to Walker. Here's Barton. He's guarded by Ellis. Shot on the wing. And a big bounce off the rim.
Wow, what a lucky
nice
bounce.
Nice job there to shake free of the defense and then drain.
Indiana leading by five. Outside Hill. Shoots off the screen. Here's Moore, and it's blocked. Out of bounds. Pacers ball as Indiana keeps possession.
That's
Taj embarrassing. Gibson's checked in for Al Jefferson. Ellis kicks to Moore. Good, and the assist goes to Ellis.
I'll take that. Makes up for it.
This quarter, the game plan is simple, folks. Get him the ball and get out of the way.
There's a screen. Gibson the screen. Doubled by Moore. Barton passes to Gibson. Rebounded by Moore. The Pacers have gone 5 of 8 from the floor here in the second quarter. Over 60% shooting. George dishes to Olynyk. That shot
wide. Like, please hit that. I know you can hit that jumper.
An excellent display of passing out there, fellas. I mean, 8 of their last 10 points have been assisted on.
And they just keep finding the open man.
Now, here's Walker. 11 points for him in that last game against the 76ers in Philadelphia.
And also, his assist total tells you about the job he did of keeping his head up and keeping his teammates involved.
Now, here is George, following the miss by Kemba Walker. And he can't extend the lead to double digits.
Had an easier time if we would have taken the screen.
Here's Kidd Gilchrist. Here's Gibson. And, there's a whistle. He was going up for a layup. And while it looked like there was some contact, I wasn't sure they were going to call a foul shot or not. But
I'm doing so poorly that the fouls are showing up on the board there.
Scotty's checked in for Kelly Olynyk. And he can't make the second free throw either. Missing both. Pacers leading by 9. Outside Hill. There's 37 seconds left to play here in the second quarter. And Moore kicks to Scott. And fouled hard that time.
I should have just gone up with that.
I tell you what, he earned his money on that foul.
Yeah, if you're going to foul, then make sure that you don't give a chance for the and one.
This is his first free throw of the game. That's good from Scott. And we finished one half of basketball.
All right, well, 13-point lead, better than trailing at halftime.
Now, it's been a one-sided affair so far through the first two quarters, but there's plenty of time to mount a comeback. Freak really making a difference here.
And in terms of points in that first half, you know, he's now at a point where we expect him to perform that way.
Greg, George is probably a guy, you know, thinking of that Rockets game. George is probably a guy I should have passed to at the end. Or somehow tried to get him open.
Let's reset the lineups courtesy of Gatorade for the second half of basketball. Setting the floor for the Hornets. We've got Michael Kidd-Gilchrist. Will Barton is out there with Kemba Walker. And it's Taj Gibson. And it's Jefferson in at center. Here's George. Michael Kidd-Gilchrist making his last shot. Ellis wide open. And another three.
Not too much. A little advantage of the confusion.
The defenders.
Walker against Hill. Walker goes in. Goes up and lays it nice and easy.
Nice move and finish. I think
locked in to Gibson there and couldn't unlock myself.
You got it. Let's get the ball inside.
There's a good screen. Monte. And George kicks to Moore. A tad short, but it's good off the front iron. Moore's got 14.
Whew.
3 for 3, and that's all.
Pretty sure if I didn't hit that with an excellent, I probably would have missed.
Here's Barton. He's guarded by Ellis. Martin passes to Walker. Releases from 15. Cannot hit. Excellent D that time from Moore. Indiana leading by 17.
Got it. Get the ball inside.
And here is Hill. He averages a bit over 6 points a game. Moore dishes to George. Shot clock at 6. Back to Moore. Indiana needs to get a shot off. And the basket by Olynyk.
They are on fire right now. That's 4 straight makes.
Hornets trail by 19. Jefferson setting the pick for Walker. No good.
The give me that.
On the glass is the difference. It's allowed them to build this lead.
And really a reflection of their superior effort level to this point. It seems to me.
Ooh, that was close to being blocked.
Seems that every pass they make is leading to a score here. I mean, that's just exquisite ball movement.
And that's because the ball is looking for the best shot, and it's really paid off for them during the run.
Now, here's Walker. His scoring has been there on a regular basis. He's averaging more than 14 points a game.
And that's
an aggressive over the back
to try to get the rebound. Just a little too aggressive.
And unnecessary.
Beat.
That's over
aggressive.
The top. That's
beat.
Doing
beat.
Too much,
aggressive.
Man. He wasn't in good position there, and he was never going to get the ball. He just wasted a foul.
Catching up on the changes now for Indiana. Hill, he's checked in for George. And it's C.J. Miles in for Ellis. The Hornets also changing it up. Rivers, he's checked in for Bart. And Jared Bayless.
Yeah, that was interesting.
They just can't miss. Everything they put up, it seems, goes in.
You know, sometimes
abandoned ship.
You're the bug, and sometimes you're the windshield. They are certainly nothing going their way.
And I'm not even sure that I'd want to be the windshield.
No, maybe the windshield wiper.
Yeah, right.
To the paint, the kick out to Hill. Good, the assist goes to Hill. Hill's got his fourth assist in this one.
Went to Hill. Fantastic. Went to George Hill there and then realized the defense collapsed, or else I would have thrown it to Solomon Hill.
The last 10 points have all come off assists.
Indiana making some.
I wasn't even paying attention. I saw it, and then I've completely forgotten what I was supposed to do there.
Kaminsky is checked in for Charlotte.
No.
Comes in for Michael Kidd-Gilchrist. There's a screen. Now here's Rivers. Not a lot of room. Feeds to Kaminsky. Charlotte again missing.
Plus +8 in the rebound differential. One more reason why they're in control.
Yeah, double-digit advantage on the scoreboard. They've taken the initiative. They've played, I think, with more purpose so far.
We're seeing the shots start to fall for them now.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, this has been an extremely efficient
second half. Oh, Turner, what are you doing?
Well, for one, he hasn't let them down. I mean, but a few other guys need to pick up the pace if they're going to be good.
Got it. Let's get the ball inside.
Outside, Lynn to the inside. Moore, and he takes the feed and stride and slams it home.
Boy, what a slick job of passing from Jeremy
Lynn. That's what you got to do.
The Hornets have gone an even 50% from the floor here in the third quarter. 4 of 8. Here's Bayless. Takes it into the teeth of the D and converts.
Contact.
You know, huge height advantage there. But because of the great body control, he's able to cancel it out.
Agreed. The body control essential in that situation. I mean, if you're giving up a bunch of height, then you better be able to manufacture things in the air.
So it's the Pacers now, following the score by Sharp. And that one's good.
They haven't been as aggressive from outside.
I'm not going to get any credit for that, but I'll take it.
They're playing smart with the lead. I like that. They're being very selective and deliberate in their offense. That's a good strategy when you're on top.
Here is Bayless, outside for Martin. From outside, off the mark. Indiana's gone 2 of 2 from long range in the third quarter so far. Hill passes to Moore. He dishes it to Miles. They grab their own miss. And Moore kicks to Lynn. And again, it's Indiana converting.
You know, it's really hard not
Way
to notice
too much
the
traffic
in the passing
there
of these two teams today.
It's
I'm surprised I didn't lose the ball somehow.
Look at the assist columns, and you see that difference as far as the fluidity in their respective offenses. Love the assist. I mean, he knew exactly where that bounce pass had to be to create that opportunity.
Kicks it to Moore. The dish to Turner. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him. Indiana shooting their fifth and sixth free throws of the game. First one falls for him. And the Hornets making a change here.
That's the Bobcats are making a change. Get it right.
Now Martin. From deep, from beyond the arc, and then some.
Wow.
Martin's got 7 points.
Good shot.
Talk about a terrific stroke. Here
we go. And we're getting underway here in the fourth quarter. The scoreboard tells the story in this matchup, but we'll see how much things change up here. Moore, he's in at power forward. George Hill out there with Ellis. Then it's Paul George, and it's Olynyk in at the five down low. That's the Pacers' five. Here's Barton.
Bum, bum. Bum,
he
bum.
He gets to Kaminsky. Off the mark there with the three-point shot.
Not only is their lead big, but their advantage on the boards is huge, too.
They've been the aggressors, plain and simple.
I'll show you how it's done.
Fighting for every loose ball. Timely passing leads to assists, and that's been the recipe for success.
Everybody on the same page, completely in sync, tremendous communication and awareness.
Now, here's Walker. Gibson the screen. Walker goes in. It's rebounded by Indiana. Moore's got rebound number 8 here tonight in the game.
Got it. Let's get the ball inside.
60 seconds off the clock here in the fourth.
Good. Quick hands there by Gibson.
Up top, Kidd Gilchrist. He's guarded by Hill. Kidd Gilchrist dishes to Walker. Here's Barton. And the layup's good off the glass.
Okay, that's more like it. A nice job here in the second. I mean, their field goal percentage is way up compared to what they did in the first half, where they shot a very low percentage. It actually was just above 30%.
Freak sets a screen for George. On the wing, Ellis. Off target from outside.
Ah, I should have been there for that.
1 of 3 from the field to start the fourth quarter. Gibson with the screen on Hill. Walker the pass to Gibson. No good.
Look at that.
The rim.
Not necessarily a strong inside presence, but he needs to polish those chances off.
And George kicks to Moore. Ellis outside. Ellis can't get that one to fall either. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Sure could, Kev. I mean, too many empty trips. They need some points.
That's good.
Boy, just an excellent
Is that their
assist.
Big shot that they nice so desperately needed?
Pacers leading by 23. Hill kicks to George. Freak sets a screen for George. The feed to Moore. Pass to Olenek. Indiana moving the ball around. They get it back. George dishes to Moore. That falls. Nice feed that time from George. George has got his 6th assist on the night.
And when they've gone to him, he has come through big time. You got to keep getting him touches.
Now here's Walker. Great D that time from Moore.
Now that's terrific defense at the rim. Got right in his path.
And you know they'll be conscious of him next time they take it inside, too. I mean, that's what really good defenders do. They make you think about their presence.
And here's Hill for 3. Olenek can't hit. The Hornets have gone just 33% from the field in the fourth quarter so far. They are 2 of 6. Shots good.
Well, after a horrible half of shooting, they bounced back here in the second half and picked up their shooting percentage quite nicely.
Now here is Hill. Outside, George. George gets a screen from Moore. Baseline try, and that one's good. Moore's got 15 points in just the second half.
Pick and pop there.
And that's exactly how they've gotten the lead right here. Easily, he's been their most consistent performer.
As simple as it gets, he's hitting everything he's looked at. Keep feeding the fire.
Now here's Kidd Gilchrist. Outside, Walker. Shot clock at 5. That short off the rim.
And this quarter, he has
short off the rim. Hey.
Goes on Taj Gibson. That is his first foul of the game.
I mean, I like the
call.
I thought the defense was just there a little late.
Yeah, it looked like it.
And now it's a scrub matchup.
Slid underneath as he got to the spot, too.
So,
actually, it's
the
B unit matchup. Now here's Lynn. Scrubs are still on the bench here.
So no problem for Indiana as they get the win. It was a tale of two
now,
teams.
No short. They tried to go for it again. Repeat of what happened yesterday.
Well, I think these fans too, Kevin, gave their team a tremendous lift. I mean, they never gave
go
up.
Go check out the Twitch highlight, disturbing short split.
The game, they were in it.
You're wondering what I'm talking about.
Get to the W.
And time now to go courtside as we send you over to Doris Burke from the sideline. Doris.
Well, Paul, what do you take away from a win like tonight in terms of what you need to continue doing as a
team? That was a nice bounce back win.
We just keep playing consistent. We just keep executing offensively. We know our defense will hold
up. Beating up the lowly Bobcats. I mean Hornets.
Paul, thank you. Thank you for your time, guys. You can hear the excitement in his voice.
Thank you, Doris. Great interview once again.
She just did not. You can hear the excitement in his voice.
For Clark Kellogg, Greg Anthony, and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan along with
welcome
our
back,
entire
Ernie Johnson,
2K
along with Shaq
crew.
And Kenny.
What is
Shaq
going on?
We're tuning in. Forward now to the
now
presentation.
To over to the
Tonight
with a double-double and was a major reason
everyone's
why
talking over
him.
Everybody.
His effort and intensity gave them the boost they needed. And Kenny, you had some words earlier while the game was going on. What do you think?
He was dead on from the field tonight, guys. I'd call his performance economical because there was no wasted opportunities. He took advantage of every good look he got. I mean, everything he put up was going in.
Boom, boom, boom. That's right, Ernie. Instruments. This guy was instrumental in the night in making sure they avoided a second straight loss. They needed somebody to step up tonight, and he was their guy.
And that'll do it for this edition of the NBA on 2K Sports.
I usually am the guy. At least I try to be the guy. I just like to dance. Woo! 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 Ow. Oh, we got here. Oh, one-on-one full court. I know what we're doing with this practice. Do the vertical jump. Ah! Oh, never mind. I was gonna do a power dunk there. See how long it takes me to get 10 shots in a row. Oh, thanks for knocking that in for me. Yeah. Woo! That was close. There's 10 shots. All right, let's get the dunks in here now. No, I need you to dunk. There we go. Oh, hello, George. You want to have a dunk contest, Turner? Let's go. Nah, never mind. Step back a little. From deep! One of these is eventually going to fall in. There! Finally! I'll grab this one. Grab that one. Shot! Oh! Someone hit the shot while I was hanging on the rim! Oh, that was amazing! I didn't even catch to see who that was. Let's see if I can catch it on the replay there. I think it was Scott, maybe. Oh, I need to hit one over the backboard. Nope. Oh, my controller batteries are low. I guess you better take care of that before the batteries die. Oh, wow! I can't believe I hit that shot. I was just making sure the mic connected properly, back properly, too. Here we go. Here we go. Got this? We got this. Ooh! I'm a point one seconds fast. Getting better. Oh yeah. I was just gonna shoot these. Yeah. Might as well, right? Alright, here we go. A little better. I'm not quite timing it right. Okay, well. Gatorade drill time. See how badly I do at this. Whoops. I didn't angle it far enough. I got a couple extra seconds tacked on there at the end. I think that's the best I've ever done on that one. Okay. Oh, there we go. I thought it froze. Whew. All right, one power dunk. And that'll be good enough for practice. To do. All right, next. Another practice. Okay. At least these are doable ones. Get a little bit of a boost. Ooh, the rematch with the Lakers. Crushed us the last time. I need all the help I can get going into this one. Pick up the ball, stupid!
All right, fellas, competition time. Beat the pro. Let's go.
Beat the pro. Go! Wow, that... Ah, wow, 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 wow. Alright, usually one of my best drills. This is obviously not my day. I'm gonna get bronze on this. Give me the ball! Well, so much for getting a good boost going in that game against the Lakers. Wow.
All right, fellas, let's change it up for a bit. How many threes can you make in a minute? Freak, start it up.
Oh. And my foot was on the line. I guess the answer to this one, how many three-pointers can I make? The answer is going to be two. Dang it. It's so hard to get in a good spot. Yep, bronze player confirmed.
Okay, that's it for now. Make sure we're iced up and rested. Go ahead, keep shooting if you want.
So that apparently just not my day. Would have been a nice shot if that would have gone in. Barrel jump here. I'll be doing one more game. Got a rematch against Lakers, and then that'll be it for the short morning sports stream. Thought I screwed that up. Well, at least got a silver that time. Anything else to do? Nope, that's it. Time for a rematch of the Lakers. Been looking forward to this game. A little revenge from the last time. Hopefully it goes better. Pre-game show.
Hello, everybody. Ernie Johnson here alongside Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. Welcome to the NBA on 2K Sports.
Madden rookie ratings.
Tonight we'll be watching the Indiana Pacers playing against the Lakers in Los Angeles. Taking a look at the Lakers, playing under 500 basketball over the last 10 games. They can do better, and they'll try to get on the winning side tonight. Well, Freak was recently selected part of All-Star Weekend. Very big honor for him, and I'm sure
there will be Ezekiel a lot
expected
Elliott.
Of him. You guys have
93
both
speed, 94
weekend.
Agility. Oh,
what's it like?
I hit the
what's
wrong
going
button.
Through their heads right now?
Well,
I was reading that.
The only thing you have to do is just enjoy the weekend. It's going to be a lot of superstars there.
93 speed, 94 agility, 95 acceleration, 90 carrying, 87 trucking, 84 ball carrier vision, 84 overall.
Guys, if you're there, you can't get caught up with all of the hype and everything.
Wow, it's going to be a good rookie to get.
You're there to be the star, not to
see some early favorites for Madden Ultimate Team.
Perform and let people remember you. Shaq always did that, and he did that great.
You know why?
Why?
I saw Halle Berry looking at me one time.
You know what I think? It was really admirable whether you were going to be
Wolf,
a dunk
Will Fuller's got 96 speed and 95 agility. Check,
that you guys got to tell impressive. And you just stayed in the room. I thought that was very impressive.
I sure
that
did.
You, yeah, that's yeah. all you did. You just went to it the hotel, big, checked in, and said, I'll it. See you Saturday
but
night
I
or see you Sunday.
But I considered the city the room.
Shaquille stayed in the room, but Shaq was partying like
yeah, Kobe's still in 2K16.
We'll see you next time.
I mean, he hadn't retired when this game was made. And he's still playing in my career, too. Even though, even this is like year four here in 2019, he's still playing. Except he's playing for the Memphis Grizzlies now. He's not with the Lakers anymore. LeBron James is with the Lakers.
For the Pacers right now, they're focused on getting off to a good start to the road trip here. They're one of the most dangerous teams in the NBA right now. No question, they've won seven of their last eight.
Because this team has played well on the road, they've got confidence anytime they go away from their own building. They know they can get the job done, and that's what they're expecting to do right now.
Yeah, and the prior success that they had on the road, oftentimes you can draw from that, and they've been put in some difficult situations in hostile environments before, and it just doesn't seem to faze them.
Let's check out Indiana's.
Come on, lucky bouncer. There we go.
Ellis is out there with George Hill. Then it's Turner, and it's George in at the three spot. So the Indiana Pacers able to put the first points up on the board. Randle kicks to James. That's good.
Just such a well-rounded offensive player. He's got
Roy Hibbert's out there. I don't think Roy Hibbert, he might have been injured last time we played them. They still crushed us. Not that he's much of a factor in the first place, other than shot blocking.
Really allowed them to escape with victory.
I thought the bench was the X factor for him. You can't rely on that kind of scoring coming from the reserves every game. But when it shows up, it's a nice weapon.
Here's Russell following the basket by George Hill. Randle kicks to LeBron. And he will.
Yeah, good thing we left LeBron wide open.
Right through off the back iron.
And it looks like he might just be on his A game today, Clark.
Hill dishes to Ellis. Off the screen. Can't get it to go. Nice D from Williams. And now in transition, here's Williams. Here we go. And Turner with the block. It's going to be out of bounds. Los Angeles will retain possession.
I don't think LeBron was going to have any chance of making that shot. Someone was going to block that one.
About a minute and a half through the first quarter. Pick by Randle. The drive by Russell. They retain possession.
Ah.
Out of bounds. They sue with last touch by Hill.
Okay, well. Looks we're kind of, sort of coming up with stops here.
Williams, that's a two-pointer. And it's good. He planted his feet.
Now, it's up for there.
Shield the defender off. For Indiana, they've gone 2-3 here to start out the game. Hill passes to Moore. Good, the assist goes to Hill. Moore's got his first basket of the night.
Oh, he could try to take a three-pointer there.
Is just getting to hang out with their peers in a non-competitive environment. I think, Clark, that I heard Freak was invited to relax with some of the big guns.
Yeah, it was Freak, Curry, Harden, and Davis all hanging out this All-Star weekend. As much as these guys compete on the hardwood, it's kind of nice to get together.
Oh, so that's what I was doing. I was hanging out with
just enjoy each other.
Harden and Curry and Davis.
And George, here we go. That misses, so no good on his
okay.
First attempt of the night.
So that's the what Harden apparently wanted to talk to me about. Over 50%. Just a big hangout party. They've accepted me.
Hibbers, the tip in.
Oh, wow.
Always better to be lucky than good when it comes to offensive rebound. And unless you're as good as he is, then those tip-ins are all about skill.
More power down after the assist, let him into the lane. And what a year it's been for Freak. It hasn't
I just push him away and then quickly run.
Part of the All-Star game. What a dream come true for him.
Dare him to catch up with me.
Freak. He earned his spot on the All-Star squad, Kevin. Making that roster
Stay
is
with
one
him,
of the
Turner.
Hardest things to do. And his play this year has been outstanding.
And so it's the Lakers with it, following the score by Indiana. Hibbert kicks to Williams, five to shoot. Williams missing again.
Sure, we get plenty of bodies down there to rebound. Shoot some Currys. Yeah, maybe if I want to lose this game. Oh, there we go. Monte Ellis has a cover.
And no matter who it is, that kind of D isn't going to get it done.
Lakers have gotten 5 of 10 shots to drop in this game so far. Right at the 50% mark. Dishes it to Randle. Feeds it to Russell. From deep. Rebounded by Moore.
You know, even though he missed that three-point shot, I think the defense has to do a better job of challenging the shot.
Yeah, and as a coach, you can really ill afford to have those types of opportunities presented against your defense.
Now, here is Russell, following the miss by Monte Ellis, and it's Hibbert missing.
That's a surprise.
Some weird,
really
goofy movement there.
The miss when the defense is not right up on it.
Randall against Moore. Ellis outside. Indiana needs to get a shot off. And Hibbert with the block. 4-on-3 break. And there's the whistle.
Oh, at least he missed it.
He'll go to the line.
And I like the fact that the defense is looking to
looking
protect
at the positives
at all costs.
Definitely saved the layup with that foul, and he'll make him earn them from the line, and that's what you want to see.
And Los Angeles will go for a different look here. Jones checked in for Julius Randle.
Yep, in the end, it doesn't matter. The only thing that mattered was not giving him an animal.
Lou Williams. And it's Norris Cole in for Russell. So an entirely new group in now for Indiana. Olenek, he's checked in for Turner. Hill comes in for George. C.J. Miles, he's checked in for Monte Ellis.
Hanging Olenek.
In for Hill. Stevenson outside. He kicks it to Cole. A three. Shot is off. So Indiana will take it the other way. Last time they met was in Indiana.
Man, that was a stinker. I mean, that's one of those games where you really can't.
Hey, yeah, that game was a stinker.
Well,
that's a great way to describe that game.
Really just a shaky performance across the board.
Yeah, and I'd have to agree with you. And you know how optimistic and positive I am. But it's hard for me to find anything positive to take away from that. That's a game you just want to forget about as soon as you can.
Moore with the bucket.
And the lead goes right back. What a seesaw affair we've got going on.
This game's right there for the taking, but neither team can quite grab hold of it. Like a slippery bar of soap there. Somebody's got to take charge here. That was a good rebound right there, but they haven't been very strong on the glass so far.
Clark, a little disparity there in the rebound numbers, but some of that comes down to how the ball bounces. Let's see if it evens out.
Olenek making like he's Seth Curry or Steph Curry. Seth Curry, yeah, wrong Curry.
Screen by Jones. Stevenson kicks to Cole. Let's it fly. No good on that last second attempt there. A good close contest so far as we finish the first quarter. Pacers lead by two. Live from the Staples Center, you're watching 2K Sports.
I don't know if he got kicked off the Hornets.
And here's Freak now on being selected to his first All-Star game.
First All-Star game? What are you talking about?
Do you think, Clark, about
oh, I skipped over the interview. Well, I made the All-Star game last year.
The who's who of the NBA, and you want your best guys front and center for that showcase, and he
weird.
Deserved it. He definitely qualified for it.
I think Lynn moved on. I don't remember if we traded for him or if we just signed him. Regardless, moves on to a better team. Two-time champions.
So an entirely new group in now for Indiana. Turner's checked in for Kelly Olynyk. Freak comes in for Mike Scott. George is checked in.
Oh, he was only a one-time champion. He came on after the second championship.
Roy Hibbert is out there.
Or after the first championship.
And it's Lance Stevenson, and it's Cole in at the one. That's the Laker five. Let's go to our sideline reporter, Doris Burton. Doris, what do you have?
Well, Kev, Freak in the last matchup against the Hornets was superb. He finished with 27 points and, as always, piling up rebound after rebound as well. What a show it was as he put up some really amazing numbers when it was all said and done. Even we marveled at his performance, Kevin.
All right, thanks so much, Doris. What a great report, and what a jaw-dropping performance that was, guys.
I couldn't believe what I was seeing. I mean, he's given himself a hard act to follow here tonight.
You know what? But as good as he was, it's hard to think there won't be at least some sort of carryover effect, guys. I mean, he still has to be riding pretty hot.
They set the pick, and George kicks to Turner. Oh, and
then ooh.
No question powered
monster dunk.
There's PG creating for a teammate. Terrific dime drop.
Cold dishes to Williams. Picked by Randall. Hibbert, the pass to Cole. Outside Williams. Pacers with the rebound.
Not sure what the D was doing there. Clearly a breakdown. You can ill afford to give a guy like him that good a look.
Nice.
That was the third straight high percentage look this defense has allowed. I mean, these defenders have got to start bumping bodies in the paint. Be more physical.
And it'll work it better. I meant to throw it to Hill at first.
Too easy right now when it comes to attacking the basket. They have
not used to seeing him in the shooting guard spot.
Hibbert with the screen. Three-pointer. That's good from Williams. The assist from Cole. 15 points for Lou Williams. Guys, seven times the lead has changed hands here now.
And we still aren't halfway through this contest yet.
Yeah, and that number should easily top double figures before it's over. And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Yeah, and that's four straight field goals now, Greg. They've allowed.
That's fine. They fall apart in the interior. That's more baskets for me.
It's stolen by Hill. The pass to Moore. From about 16.
Oof, that was a little short.
Man, that is a missed opportunity right there.
And he'll be the first to tell you, Greg, that's one he should have knocked down.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I was supposed to be setting screens for scorers. Whoops.
And it's been a back-and-forth game so far with no ground given through the first half. Third quarter starting here now.
Talk about a terrific game for Williams. 15 points, and he sprayed home three three-pointers as well.
This is really production.
Well, LeBron didn't play much in that second quarter.
Well, we've got a moment.
Resting him up a lot for the second half.
On the court right now for the Pacers. Moore in it, power forward. George Hill out there with Ellis. Then it's Turner. And it's George in at the three spot. Indiana's gone 3-7 tonight from three-point territory. Kicks it to Moore. There's the triple. Offensive rebound. Turner. And he battles for the ball and gets the
Works.
Second chance bucket. Turner's got the first bucket of the third here for Indiana. Russell kicks to Randall. Outside Williams. Nice ball movement here by the Lakers. Can't get it to
Woo!
Go. Indiana leading. Out to the right wing. Moore against James. Unloads from 13.
That one Take that, LeBron.
Right butt drops in for him.
He's got some serious momentum going right now. He's been great all day. Even last game, he was on fire.
Hibbert hits the bucket.
Boy, the D has to show a little more fight on the interior than they did on that trip. They've got a battle inside.
This game has been a battle, and maybe they're starting to just run out of gas a little bit.
Move the ball.
And George.
Woo! Lift off.
And that's a punch to the jaw. This game as tight as it can be, and he pulls something off that we might not even see in the All-Star game, Kevin.
But, Clark, I don't know that he planned it out too far in advance. That was one of those things that you know, just
Oh, I'm happened. Sure you'll see something like that in the All-Star game.
I really don't. I think that he's one of those guys that just plays off of instinct.
See nothing but that in the All-Star game.
Making those kinds of plays, even
Not like they play
game.
Defense at all.
And that last replay courtesy of Kia.
You know, he just hasn't looked right to me a bit. Out of sorts, if you will. Something's off with his mechanics, at least as I look at it.
Clearly a foul.
Yeah, he took a shot there, earned those free throws.
The Pacers shooting their first free throws tonight. The first trip to the stripe in this one. And the Lakers with some changes. Omer Asik, he's checked in for Hibbert. Jones comes in for Julius Randle.
Thanks for that fine getting offensive rebounds.
Then
really
for the Pacers,
had a chance
CJ
to get them.
Comes in for George. And it's Jeremy Lin in for George Hill. And Jones slams it home.
Ah, let him get around me.
Going all out to get the second chance points. Just a terrific finish.
There was no one that was going to prevent MGA from converting that one.
Well, clearly this is the kind of game that could come
Whoops.
Down to one or two plays. And he wants to be the guy to make those plays.
all messing with me when it's playing in different positions.
He's picked up 6 points from behind the arc.
I love the rhythm. His outside
stroke. Yeah, pretty much. But there's no defense.
Olenek's checked in.
Crazy three-point shots. Alley-oop after alley-oop. Dunk after dunk. Crazy reverse layups. Yeah.
Both shots good from the stripe. Lakers trail by 6. Russell kicks to LeBron.
Should call it the James Harden game. All offense, no defense.
Trying his luck deep. Rebounded by Moore. Moore's got his 6th rebound on the night. Looking at Los Angeles, they took the win in their last game against the Rockets in Houston.
And if you look at the numbers, guys, I mean, what jumps out at you is the balance they had offensively.
Very satisfying road win, because you're right. There was tremendous balance displayed. I mean, the crowd was basically stunned at how they were able to dismantle that defense.
Jones with the screen on Lynn. Russell dishes to Jones. A tad short, but it's good off the front iron.
Timely passing leads to assists, and that's been the recipe for success.
Everybody on the same page, completely.
Go, Linick. Yeah, you torch. Whoever that is.
Shot quality is very good here, and they're making the most of it.
Oh, it's a sheik.
Yeah, converting at a really high level.
Ah, sheik.
The field goal percentage.
Oh, man, the Turkish hammer. He was known in Chicago. I don't know if anyone still calls him that anymore.
Let's go to the 2K leaderboard to see which players have had the most success from the stripe this month.
Guys, he's been an absolute dead-eye shooter from the free throw line. His concentration just never wavers.
Here's what the Lakers are going with right now. Lance Stevenson comes in for Omer Asik.
And tasked with guarding LeBron, this should be fun.
With a change here too. Hill's checked in.
No matter what they've tried, the D just has not been able to deny them the ball in the paint.
And it's a big key thus far in this game, Clark, because whenever they've gotten the ball in the paint, good things
happen. Oh, there we go. There's Olenek pulling out the contact dunk.
And we know he's capable of those memorable dunks.
Yeah, and when he's got a lead like that, why not take a few chances? A lot more engaging and entertaining than just doing the old ho-hum one-hander. I mean, no one really
this is going to be a rough stretch.
He's able to knock down the off-balance shot.
Outside, Lynn, and there's the feed to Moore. He dishes it to Hill. And Miles kicks to Moore.
Oops, that's not where I wanted to go.
1:33 left to play in the third. Roberson the pass to Stevenson. Screen by Jones.
Fast enough.
Stevenson drives in. The timely screen gave him a step, and he took it all the way.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. 5 buckets in a row from the paint.
And on the flip side, Greg, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior. They've got to offer more resistance here.
Back to Lynn. Lynn gets a screen from Moore. Lynn dishes to Moore. Yes! And a nice assist for Lynn. 14 points for Freak.
He's been one of their more reliable options today, guys. I mean, his shooting has led them to this lead.
LeBron with a screen on Lynn. And Cole kicks to Jones. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two. That one on Olenek. The Lakers have been good at the free throw line in this one. 7 of 8.
Shooting from Los Angeles, Terrence Jones.
The first free throw is good. And the Lakers
bounce.
Roy Hibbert's checked in for James.
Yeah, missed one of these, right?
In for Andre Robertson. And the Pacers also making a change.
Couple bounces.
Paul George, he's checked in for CJ Miles. Pacers leading by 3. Down low, here's Moore. And he takes the feed in stride and slams it home.
Much better.
Big fella throwing it down with a vengeance.
Back to matchups against centers and power forwards, and not against LeBron.
But no scoring yet from him. Stevenson against Lynn. And it's Stevenson missing. Pacers have gone 9 of 10 on their attempts in the third quarter. That is 90% from the field. What a roll they're on. And Hill has it in the corner. And a wide open look for Lynn. Drills the three-pointer. Lynn's got the lead up to 8 now for Indiana.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Well, when you look at the assist totals, hey, they've been clearly the better team.
Oh, that's right. Delvedova's here, too.
Well, it's been an exciting game. Plenty of offense as we head to the fourth quarter.
LeBron took them with him. Went to the Lakers.
We're just moments away from the start of the fourth quarter. Stay with us. Final period of play just about to start. Pacers leading by 8. We got Lance Stephenson. Handle out there with then there's Lewis Williams. And it's Russell in a point guard. That's the Laker 5.
Well, that's not exactly the greatest way to start off the fourth quarter.
The Lakers shooting 38% from the field. A pretty weak showing for them. Williams passes to Hibbert.
I guess good thing it didn't lead to a basket.
By Los Angeles. Inside. Good, and the assist goes to Russell. Russell's got 3 assists tonight.
You know, it's really going to be all.
Oh, yeah, 2K16 is great. Yeah, I definitely recommend getting it.
That high quality shot right there.
No question. That's their goal down the stretch here. I think finding those close range rhythm shots.
Oof. Quick reaction.
Ball's against Williams. Now the dish to Randall on the wing, Stevenson.
Six of course, with the next NBA 2K coming out, and I mean, it'll be towards the end of the year. Save up money for that instead.
I tell you what, he earned his money on that foul.
Yeah, if you're going to foul, then make sure that you don't give a chance for the and one.
And guys, let's
keep an eye out on sales
so far for Indiana.
Boy, their passing has been picturesque, a thing of beauty in both halves. More than a few of their baskets have come off assists.
Yeah, but I also like the balance because they're doing.
I
want to
be a first time. You know, a lot of people skip kind of really games right in between. I've skipped games in between. I think before 2K15, I think the last one I had was 2K12. I went from 2K12 to 2K15. Look, speak here.
He's got 10 rebounds and also a block shot. He's a one-man wrecking crew out there.
And then I went back, kind of got back-to-back copies.
James checked in for Los Angeles, and so Moore nails both of them.
Mostly because they had the Michael Jordan special edition one.
To the line here in the second half.
Had to get that Legends
edition. Exactly the right thing to do with the lead. Keep going at defenders and find a way to get yourself to the line.
And the foul goes on Roy Hibbert. That'll be his second foul of the game.
This year it's Kobe as the Legends cover. I'm gonna end up getting the Legends editions again.
Pacers leading by 8. And stolen by Williams.
Oh, there's a surprise. Ellis dribbling into a steal.
Just over a minute and a half played here in the fourth. Hill with it. And it's Ellis penetrating. No good.
Terrific job that dump time. Dump that off to Turner.
The rim. I mean, it's not an easy task.
Not being too much traffic there.
When he's headed to the bucket like that. Good job.
Here's Williams. Excellent D there from George. And Indiana shooting has just been outstanding tonight. 56% as a team in this game. That's good. And 12 points.
Ellis finishing in a lot of traffic there.
By having a bigger defender on him down low. And I really thought he would be.
You know, at first glance, you wouldn't think that he'd be comfortable in that particular
the thing I liked about my career is, well, for at least like year one, the right kind of new story-esque mode
lock at six. Here's Hibbert.
They introduced.
Rebounded by Moore. Pacers leading by eight.
Directed by Spike Lee.
It's George on the wing. Good, and it's Hill picking up the assist. That's now 8 points here for George.
And he could be the guy to put this game out of reach.
Patience. Patience. Taking early threes.
It was written by him as well, too.
The transition points.
Make yeah, written and directed. That's what I thought. I don't know why he would just direct it.
Great shot. Let the game come to you. We're forcing the issue too much.
I haven't really looked into 2K17 to see if they're doing anything like that for my career as well. They're kind of doing more. We'll go back to kind of just the basic storyline. Nice to kind of have that storyline feel to it. Makes the game and the mode more immersive.
Has an update from the sidelines.
Yes, during that Coach Byron Scott had some words for his team. They've been getting torched with
it's
all
it's kind of the point of my career.
Kind
of
simply said, we
immersive aspect to it.
Shooters, guys.
Put yourself in
and it's leaving them
the NBA world.
And they make the adjustment, guys.
Hibbert, good work.
Yeah, it's been about in and rebounding. Out. Really, that's the dividing line in this game.
Yep, and they've simply shown more aggressiveness, guys. More desire to secure the ball.
And here's Ellis for three. It's good. With that basket, he's now 5 for 9.
He might not have the long range ability of some other
guys. It's weird. It wouldn't be so weird if he was retired at this point in the game. But since he's still playing and playing for the Grizzlies, it makes it a little weird.
But it's been a different story here since the break.
And he drops in the layup off the glass. Moore's got the lead up to 13 now for Indiana.
And such a steady hand. I mean, he's one of those guys that's really allowed them to take the lead.
Well, he's just so reliable and dependable and consistent, especially here today. I mean, his shooting percentage is off the charts.
Plenty of daylight on that. And that's now 9 points for D'Angelo Russell.
You know, the defense has got to do a much better job of fighting over those screens.
And, Greg, especially when the ball is in his hands. I mean, come on now. You know he doesn't miss too many open looks like that.
And Freak throws it down.
The one-hand slam is so sweet when it's his hand doing the slam.
Oh, yeah.
This matchup against Hibbert is
really,
it's actually a really big mismatch. He's got the height advantage, but apparently got a little bit of a speed advantage.
Pacers leading by 12. Outside Turner.
That's what they need to do, stick LeBron on me, but not even that's going to help him.
High for the two-handed dunk.
He has really shot the ball extremely well, as you'd expect. Like we say, he's been making sweet string music all day long.
Down low, here's James. The basket drops, and he's fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
Curse you, LeBron.
Here, and they've had a little bit of success as they try to cut into that deficit. And getting it inside is one way to try to chip away at it.
Jones checked in for the Lakers. Jeremy Lin, he's checked in for Indiana. And it's more.
Too easy.
Hey, really, I like the fact that even with
I'll try to make a buzzer beater shot if I get the opportunity.
To me, that's a sign of a really good team, Greg, because you should always be playing against the game and yourself. I know there's an opponent out there, but when you have a lead, it's all about continuing to execute. Do what you do and stay true to that. And I like that.
Depends on who gets last possession.
Kind of attack that they have.
And at this point, just sort of running through the paces, as it appears it'll be a nice win here for Indiana.
Tonight, they did a great job of getting everyone involved. They had the good passing, and that led to some open shots.
Yeah, it's a fun way to play, and it's fun to watch, too.
And the effort here tonight.
All right, Paul George, I see you there.
Will go down as their 48th win.
Important. With this win, they split the season series at a game apiece and also avoid the sweep. And that
they can't guard us on the perimeter. Spread the floor and isolate up top. Spacing, tell us. Spacing. I mean, they won't see each other in the regular season again.
again until next season.
And beyond the actual result of this game, fans are going to look back and, and see this was just a
no buzzer beater
performance for Freak.
So I'm going to get the rest to rest the rest of the game.
So no problem for Indiana as they get the win. A solid win on the road for them. This building was dead silent by the time GA this one wound down.
And that's what you want to do. Take the crowd out.
That's some nice payback there.
Any chance to lift their team up at the finish.
Vengeance. Ugly loss to them last time.
Saying thanks for watching. And now to our good friend Ernie Johnson, who is standing by in the studio.
Bad game, 26 and 13 is a double-double. 3 assists, block, 12 for 15.
The 2K Sports post-game show.
Welcome back, Ernie Johnson, along with Shaq and Kenny the Jet. Let's quickly move forward now to the presentation of our Jordan Player of the Game. Freak! The entire second half was just phenomenal. You could see there was no way he was going to let them lose. Let's get your opinion, Kenny.
He flat out dominated. I mean, you see the kind of plays he was making all over the court. This is a game, no matter who they put on him, he wasn't going to be denied. His power was in full effect.
His accuracy from the field was pretty eye-catching. I mean, if he was shooting the ball, it was going in. You rarely see a performance like this with this crazy high shooting percentage. Wow.
And that'll do it for tonight. For Kenny Smith, Shaquille O'Neal, Kevin Harlan, and our illustrious 2K Sports crew, this is...
Yeah, it's always nice to get a little bit of revenge. Still see that game two in my head. I think we're losing by 20, 30 at one point. Almost came back towards the end, just ran out of time. If you want to go see that game and get watch me get my butt handed to me. Now, let's see here. When would that have been? Wow. Is it further back than I remember, or did I skip over it somehow? I feel like it was relatively recent. It was longer than I thought. Oh, yeah, there it is, all the way back in November. So, just gotta find the stream where I'm playing games in November. I don't know what stream that would have been, but... Let's see, I usually play three streams, so let's see. Started with the one, I guess, a one. That would have been two streams. Streams, four... Five, six. It was actually pretty about 10 or so streams ago. So it seems like it was a lot closer than that. But that's the date. If you want to go watch it, it's an ugly game. I don't know why you would want to waste your time doing it, but hey, some people enjoy watching other people suffer. That's why there's a term called a sadist. Not a Satanist, don't get him confused with that. Buy boost here, might as well. Although a Satanist can be a sadist and a sadist can be a Satanist. But the two don't necessarily have to be grouped together. A person can be a sadist and not a Satanist. And a person can be a Satanist, and I say, anyway, I don't know where this conversation is going. So anyway, before this gets any weirder, gonna go ahead and wrap things up here today for the short morning sports stream. Pick things up again tomorrow morning, and continue year four. Getting close to the All-Star break here. Wondering if I'll be part of the dunk contest again this year, and I learned, I actually did a little practicing, kind of worked a little bit with the timing so I kind of get a better understanding of how it works. Last year, I didn't even complete a dunk at the dunk contest because I had no idea how the quick time event thing kind of works. So this year got a little bit of a better handle on it, so hopefully if I do get invited back, which after last year, maybe not, if I do get invited back, it'd be a little bit better at it. So wrapping everything up here, I don't know why I said that, that wasn't really necessary. Because I was thinking the wrong thing, said the wrong thing. I'm rambling again. Looking at the schedule for the rest of the week, coming up today, I'll be in Rocket League this afternoon, be playing more of the new Hoops mode. My friend and fellow, or longtime viewer, Mr. Rairai, will hopefully be there this afternoon. He said he was going to try to make it because Thursday when I played for the first time, we kind of teamed up at the end, went 3-0. We actually made a pretty good team and like to put it to the test even more, see if it was just a little fluke Thursday, if we just played against some bad players or if we're actually a pretty decent team ourselves. So, yeah, hopefully he'll be on this afternoon and we'll get a chance to put that to the test. So yeah, more Hoops mode in Rocket League, kind of a basketball themed day today. So that's what's coming up this afternoon. Rest of the week, tomorrow I'll be back in NBA 2K16 for the short morning sports stream. We'll continue my career, and then in the afternoon I'll be in Star Wars Battlefront ads. Tomorrow is May the 4th, so May the 4th be with you. Star Wars Day makes sense to play Battlefront on Wednesday. That's the one kind of change. You know, last week, in the last couple Wednesdays, we've been going through Left 4 Dead 2 campaigns, Left 4 Dead 1 and 2 campaigns. And I said last week, of course, next Wednesday we'd finish up Left 4 Dead, not thinking that next Wednesday was May the 4th. So just one little slight change in terms of order. I'd still be finishing up the Left 4 Dead 2 campaigns, but I'd be doing that Thursday afternoon instead of tomorrow afternoon, because, like I said, it makes sense to play Star Wars Battlefront on Star Wars Day instead of the day after Star Wars Day. So that's one little minor change. So yeah, tomorrow will be NBA 2K16 Star Wars Battlefront, and then Thursday NBA 2K16 in the morning, and then Left 4 Dead 2. We'll finish up the last couple campaigns in the afternoon. Let's see here. I think that covers everything. If anything changes at all, of course, I'll let you know on Twitter, which is at 4MoreSports, YouTube.com/DSADeathAndy589. If you want to get caught up on any past streams, you can find links to everything in the channel info section if you're watching on Twitch, or if you're watching this later on YouTube, you can watch. Sorry, I got a little thrown off there for a second. But for some reason, on the Twitch app, it says my stream is paused, yet I can clearly see it going over here. Okay, that's weird. That's a little bit glitched. Anyway, where was I? You can find links to everything if you're watching on Twitch in the channel info section. If you're watching later on YouTube, you can find them in the description area. If you are watching this on YouTube, feel free to hit that subscribe button. Give this video a good old thumbs up. And of course, if you like to help support the stream, you can do so by sharing the stream with friends, family, whoever. You can help out by following me here on Twitch and continue to come back and watch yourself. Or you can help out by donating, help cover general living costs, buying games, upgrading equipment, basically keeping things running here. Any of those methods are all a big help and would be greatly appreciated. So I think that covers everything now. Yep, I think that's good. Therefore, until the next time you decide to tune in, I will see you at that point. But until then, have a great day, everybody.